Okay, so now let's see one more simple program. Now let's go forward and add two numbers. Okay, now I want to add 2 and 3. So sum of 2, 3 should be 5. I'll give values 2, 3 and output should be 5. Now let us see how can we write a simple add Java program. So first you have to declare two numbers, 2 and 3. So how would you tell Java that I am declaring two values? So values in the sense, are you declaring an integer? Are you declaring a float? Float in the sense 2.5, which you define in points. So if you want to define integer, you have to say, okay, I'm giving an integer for you. And int, this is the return type you need to give. Okay. And let us take this 2 into one variable. Okay. Let's take that variable as a. A equals to 2 and semicolon at the end. So now this step, it takes the value 2 and put it in a variable called a, which is an integer. So before you actually put this 2 into this a value, you have to tell what is the state of this a. Is it an integer or it is a string? You have to tell. So in that way, it will take this digit into that variable. If you say string, it will take the 2 as a string into that variable. And you cannot add two strings, right? Can you add I plus started? No, it will throw an error. But you can add 2 integers. So that's the reason you have to be very specific in defining a return type. Okay, now I want to take 3 and I have to put in one more variable. I'll say integer, I'm declaring a new variable b and I am putting the value 3, semicolon. Right. Now I have 2 variables. Now Java have 2 variables. In that 2 is stored in a variable, which is an integer, and 3 stored in b variable, which is an integer. Now I want to sum up these 2. Fine. I'll say a plus b. Fine. After summing up, I'll write the value of the sum into one variable again, and I'll say it as sum. Now sum variable have the addition of a plus b, that means 2 plus 3, that is 5. Okay, again there is an error because it don't know what variable it has to, what return type it should take. It should take integer or string. You have to give. If you add 2 integers, the output will be for sure integer only. So you have to say int. So whatever variable you declare, you have to use return type for it. Okay, so you cannot just simply define a variable without writing a return type. That you can do in other languages like Python or some other, but in Java you have to define something like this. Okay, we have successfully summed up. I have taken 2 variables and summed and finally thrown into some variable. Right, now I want to see this output. So if you want to see something in the output, you say system dot, just copy the same sentence or follow the same sentence format. Right. Now comes a tricky. I want to print sum. To print something in the output, you have to write it in double quotes if it is a string. But here if I write like this, the output will be sum only. Because see, the system out println prints whatever you send as an argument. Here you sent I started Java learning as an argument, so it printed that. If you pass sum as an argument, it prints the just text, plain text called sum. But you want the value present in this sum. You need not want this sum text should be in your output, but you want some value which is present in this sum variable. Okay, if you run this program, output will be something like, let me show you. Yeah, you can see I started Java learning and sum, but here I want output as 5. For that, what you need to do, something like sum, even it prints as caps, no change. So in that case, if you want to print the variable value into the output, you have to write without double quotes. When you write something without double quotes, then system.outprintln treats it as a variable, okay, and it prints the value present in this variable. When you just give double quotes again, then it reads as a simple plain string and it just prints the text. That's it. But when you write that without double quotes, then Java treats that it as a variable and prints the value present in that variable. But make sure that variable should be defined in that program. For example, if I write someone with removing double quotes, okay, Java treats as a variable, but it's saying error, because there is no someone variable you declared in the class and you are asking me to print the variable someone value. Whenever there is no variable itself, how can I print the value? Okay, make sure you define the variable and declare here without double quotes. And now output will be fine. Okay, now it successfully summed up. Okay, now I have one more requirement. So I want something like this as output. Sum is 5. This should be my output. Okay, now how do you write that in your system.outprintln method? Let us see. Okay, now this is a simple plain text. I can do like this. Sum is. Okay, if I print now, it just give me sum is, because I written in double quotes. But this 5 is a variable value that I want it here. But that should not be in double quotes, right? So for that, if you want to separate the string and variable, you can do that with a concatenating operator, that is plus. Okay, in Java, plus is a concatenation operator which joins string and variable. Okay, now you can write sum. If you just say like this, something like, it will throw an error, because till here it is sum is, which prints as a normal string, but here you want a variable value which should not be in double quotes, but you have to give plus concatenation operator, then only Java treats, understands that, okay, this is a string and I got concatenation operator. That means the very next value what I am getting is a variable. Fine. So now you see the output. It's like sum is 5. You can see that sum is 5. If you remove this concatenation operator, Eclipse will throw an error. You can understand that, okay, I'm missing something symbol like that. Okay, so that's how you can work with both integers and strings and the concatenation operator, and how do you declare variables in Java and how can you sum up them. Okay, yeah.